Oh, look, they must be tingling on every square part of their body, Grant. I know Paul has wanted this fight. When he went into the last fight, he tells me that Paul wasn't quite right in his life.
For the Australian National Anthem.
And we're expecting to see a different Paul Grimer this year, this time. In one way, terrifying.
Look at those boys ready to get in. Straight across the ring.
Straight across. Wants to use any advantage he thinks he's got from their last skirmish. Oh, Paul's fighting a different fight for Paul.
They're both ripping in straight away.
Absolutely.
That was good movement by Vic then.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nice kicking by Vic.
Interesting, straight up for the pair of the boys. Interesting. Oh, look. No furling out. I guess they know each other well after.
Yeah, they're straight into this fight. This is going to be a hell fight, this. Oh, it was a big up. That was a nice kick by Vic.
I tell you, I saw a bruise on the inside of Chan Chuck Fay's leg tonight. The poor Grimer
put there in training. Oh, nice kick by Grimer.
And it's huge. Paul is pumped up. Look at Super Vic!
Yeah, Vic's rolling, that's for sure.
Absolutely.
Grimer comes back. Vic, beautiful turn. Spin and back kick from Vic. Didn't find the mark real good.
His kicks come out of nowhere.
Grimer's pumping them punches in.
He is.
They're working on the lower legs then. These boys are into it.
Oh, look.
Nice kick from Grimer.
He's got to be hurting inside of the sixth spot. Oh, look. There's another one. How do you call a fight like this? How do you call a fight where there's so much action?
Vic's just turned Grimer around. He's got him back in the corner now.
Yeah. Well, look, that's a trade-off of punches.
Oh, nice body work by Grimer.
Look, it's all over the body. There's a few marks on it everywhere. And Paul's just walking up.
Nice right hand by Vic.
Paul's doing is walking in and take on.
He kicked the front leg. That was a nice move by Stevick.
A smart move, a psychological move, my friend. And out comes the side kick and the round kick from nowhere. Just from nowhere he brings him out.
Great round. Great round of fighting for the first round. Stevick was confident.
Yep.
Grimer just walked back casual. Paul doesn't really get revving until about the third or fourth round.
Paul's got a little bit of red mark over the top of his left eye. It's nothing. Just like a glove mark, that's all. And I just am amazed at Super Vic's capacity to bring those kicks out from really what is nowhere, Grant. Just nowhere.
That's Steve's ability. He's knocked many of an opponent out by just bringing him out from nowhere and kicking him across the shin, across the side of the head.
He was telling me that he spars with Stefan Scriggins, who I understand was a boxer of some repute.
He was a Australian amateur boxer, which that shows me why Steve Vick, his boxing skills are very tuned tonight.
And he's been sparring with Ian Jacobs.
Great kick fighter. Obviously a little bit heavier than Steve, and testing in sparring sessions.
Well, side kick. Just straight out to the head with those side kicks.
Grimer straight in there. Look at this. Grimer wants to make this a brawl, and Vic's answering the brawl.
Yeah, with a brawl. Just mentioned the ball about holding.
Right hook! Right hook!
I tell you have to look at Steve. He's got a savage right hook.
That is a savage. Vic's working real hard too.
Yeah.
Vic's boxing has improved 100%.
Absolutely.
Look at this. These boys are going toe to toe. Vic just moved back from Grimer. Nice spinning kick which didn't connect. Grimer still walks back up, throwing shots. Just keeps throwing shots. Nice uppercut from Grimer.
I know. At the moment, Steve is doing very good work.
He's hurt, Vic. Vic's out of trouble now.
That was a big kick. Oh, but he's answered it with a few punches. He's answered with a few punches.
Overhand right from Vic didn't catch him up.
Vic's keeping out of his way for the moment. He's just getting over that kick.
Oh, look at that kick. Grimer just walks in and keeps throwing him.
Well, he's a walk-up fighter.
Nice thigh kick from Grimer. Nice inside thigh kick from Vic.
Walk-up fighter. Scared him nobody, scared him nothing.
Oh, no. It was well done. That was well done by Grimer. Grimer walks by. Nice spinning kick from Vic.
A right hook. That's what Paul said. He saw a little bit of humour in that and said, here, take this hook. It's yours.
Oh, nice uppercut from Grimer.
That's for you. But Steve's taking those, mate. Taking them.
That was a great round of boxing.
A good round.
How tough are these blokes?
Mate, how tough? They're tough. They're tough. I've always said the state of origin football players are tough. These blokes are tougher.
Yeah, these are great fighters, these guys. They've gone toe to toe for the first two rounds.
Champions.
No feeling out here.
No.
Straight into it.
How long are we going to be after 7 or 8 of this? They're going to be tired,
gonna be
mate.
Sore.
And sore. But they're still going to be there doing it. You know, I talked to Steve about the last fight. I asked him if it was an easy fight with Paul. He said, no fight is easy. He said he did the preparation in the ring and the strategy he had was spot on. He said, this time, we've done all the work. We're there to fight. We're going to put on a good show, whatever happens. What a sportsman.
That's a great professional attitude.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, they got new coaches a year ago, and they've done him very proud.
Nice side kick from Vic. Grimer just keeps walking up. Vic's on his bike a little bit this round.
Yeah.
Vic's on his bike a bit this round.
I reckon Paul's guard is much higher than I've ever seen it before.
Nice right rip to the body. Vic turns him around on the ropes.
Oh, yeah.
Grimer works on the inside thigh, and Vic comes back with a kick.
Yeah, Paul's ready for that jumping stuff, mate. I don't think that phases him a lot.
Grimer, well, nice right hand from... Didn't phase Steve Vic. No. Right hand didn't phase Vic. Working in close at the moment.
Oh, that was a good right.
That was a good right hook by Vic.
Yeah.
Geez, Paul Grimer, he's a tough boy. Look at this.
They're just so well conditioned, Grant. They're just taking it. And they're not being hurt.
They're just tough guys, that's why.
Oh, that was
an overhand right just missed Vic. It was thrown by Grimer.
Just as well it missed, I'll tell you there.
Vic, nice kick. Grimer goes to the body.
Paul's got a bit flat-footed for that. Oh, but he's kicked through.
Grimer walking up, trying to trap him on the ropes.
Yep.
Steve's on his bike a little bit. Steve's moving around the ring.
But to see Paul's
overhand right from Grimer. Connects on the side of Vic's head.
Yes. Oh. There's Chanchuk Clay's training coming into position. No doubt. There it comes again. Chanchuk Clay is an expert, his people are that.
Straight right hand from Grimer connects. Nice kick to the thigh.
Kick for kick. Punch for punch.
Punch for punch. This is a war. This is a war. Look at those boys go. Right in centre. Grimer going with the body.
Yes.
Kicks over that leg out from Vic.
That was a good left hand to Steve Vic from Paul Grimer.
Steve Vic's on his bike. Nice kick. Yeah. He's Vic's dangerous with those kicks
to the head. But Paul says no, mate. The glove was there.
Vic's dangerous with those kicks to the head. This is the best fight. Look at this.
Oh, uppercut. Hook for the right from Paul.
Grimer just throwing from everywhere. Down, up, down, up.
Well, look, Steve Vic is there. He's good with his hands as his feet, too.
Vic's improved his boxing skills out of sight.
Oh, look, uppercut left, uppercut right from Paul.
Oh, no,
would you like to judge this one? How do you judge a fight when there's something happening every half a second?
When three rounds have been going toe to toe, this is an awesome fight.
It is. Paul was telling me that he's been training hard for the last 8 weeks. The last week, He slept in the ring as he does every night last week of the fight.
Slept in the ring?
He sleeps in the ring every night. Even though his wife is pregnant, just found out she's pregnant, he still slept in his ring. It's the way that he finds his affinity with where he's going to do his work in his office. A bit like what you were saying, right? His training strategy was unusual because he hasn't done much running. He felt that that wasn't what was needed. What was needed was the technique and power development in his deliveries. And do you notice how his hands have got away from being open, where he used to be open to front kicks to the face? His hands are tight, very tight and up high.
He's reading Vic's high kicks well too. He's obviously watched the other fight when Vic connected with a lot of those head kicks. And obviously, you know, said that's the area he had to work on. And he's improved that area.
Both of the fighters have improved. Both of them. And they're just fabulous fighters.
Walk up start for Paul Grimer. Vic comes with the side kick.
It was moved aside by Paul.
It's a great kicker, this Steve Vic.
You don't see many axe kicks.
Nice kick to Grimer's head there.
Oh, yeah, but Paul can take that.
Grimer's still trying kicks. To work on him close.
I tell you what Steve does so quick is that side kick off the lead leg head high. That's a very quick kick by him.
Geez, Grimer's working on the body hard there. Vic is starting to get a few welts around that left side of the body.
Now there's Paul on the inner thigh again, Grant. He's hit that inner thigh a few times.
He's working that inner thigh, but that's for sure.
That's got a tell on you, hasn't it, after a while?
After a while, it certainly does.
Oh, good kick.
Vic's working on his body. Grimer just walking up. Determined look on his face.
Yeah. Oh, punch, take my kick. That's Paul. I'll take your punch. Here's mine.
Look at Vic the way he kicks.
Yeah.
Spin and back kick from Vic.
On the gloves of Paul.
Right hand from Grimer.
Paul's taking a few on the gloves and
there
gives him one
the
back.
There goes the thigh again of Vic.
He likes that inside thigh.
He's working that thigh area.
The left leg of Steve Vic's got a few red marks. Oh, good side kick.
Yeah, he's so
very good.
That was a world-time side kick.
Yep. Very good side kick.
Grimer's still walking up. Vic's still on his bike trying to...
Overhead right again.
Paul's got to get in there and keep in close.
I think he's got to keep going for that inner thigh. Keep putting his damage on it. Steve's got him on top there.
And Steve's got Grimer.
Oh, big hit. Big
Grimer's gone down with the right hand.
Big hit.
Grimer's gone down. He's got it. The count's up to six. He's taking the eight count.
That was a big right hand.
That was a big right hand.
Oh.
The end of the round. I think that's safe for Grimer.
I think Paul was a bit lucky there, mate. I couldn't actually see that right hand from where I'm sitting, Grant, but I saw it come through fast. I didn't see where it hit him on the head, but it did.
It hit him straight on the side of the temple on the left hand side.
Is that right? Not often the Paul gets hit. Not often at all.
Not often he goes down either.
Never. Very rarely.
Vic's corner must be feeling pretty happy at the moment.
Oh, look, Steve.
Oh, it's been a war for four rounds.
Well, his hands are as good as his feet.
He's a great fighter, Steve.
Well, that's why he's ranked number two in the world, Greg.
Obviously.
That's why he's ranked. And he's trained as well, so he's just telling him he's doing everything right, and he is. He's not done anything wrong. His kicks are well placed. His hands are well placed. Watch Paul.
Paul's got to stay in there close. He's going to hurt. He's going to hurt Vic to get a bit of respect. If he lets Steve get around on that bike, he's going to out-kick him. He's going to hurt him with those kicks.
Give me a towel.
No, he's got to be in there doing it. Well, Paul's got the heart to do it, mate. I think Paul's ready for that.
Paul fights back.
Yeah,
Steve's still on his bike.
Paul seems to have shook off that punch.
Get out of there!
But he's a bit wary. I hope he can put some sting back in
the window. Grimer looking for the body again. He's still walking up. He's got to get some rapid movement going. He's got to stay in there and work.
I tell you, Steve's doing it now.
Now move!
Steve's doing it.
Get off the rope!
Steve's coming out the lefts, the rights, the kicks. The referee, Billy Sulis, just saying, hey, don't hang on, guys.
Go!
Paul's going to get in close, going to get some rats on movement and miss those punches and kicks.
Paul needs a sting, doesn't he?
On the bike.
Don't
sting. He's got to stay there. He's got to get some respect off Vic.
No!
Now Vic's caught him with an uppercut.
Paul's going to take it.
Nice kick. Arms from Vic.
He's a tough man.
Right hand from Grimer.
Well,
Good kick from Vic.
I got to tell you, Steve, he looks very fresh for Steve Vic to me.
There's a big one from Vic, sorry.
Lucky he didn't kick through, Grant. Better kick through, could have done some mischief. Well, I think you're right. Paul's got to bring something out here.
Paul's got to bring something out. He's getting work on.
Yeah.
He's letting Vic work. He's letting Steve do what he wants to do.
Yeah, he's getting done. Oh, there's a good uppercut, though. Just when you think Paul's tired, out he brings a big punch.
Right hand!
And his adrenaline. His adrenaline.
Paul just keeps walking up. He's got to move his head.
Yep.
He's got to get out of the way or something.
He's working that left leg. There's three good kicks to his thigh, but I don't know if it's having an effect, you know, Grant. I just don't know.
Nice right hand from Grant. A nice thigh kick from Grant.
But Vic answers with a front kick straight under the chin.
Yeah. I tell you, Paul got through that on adrenaline, mate. I reckon he got through that on conditioning, on training. And I reckon, I mean, I hate to say it, but I reckon Steve Vic looked the better fighter in that round.
In that round, Steve Vic was getting on top of it.
He pulled out the punches. He pulled out the kicks. He pulled out the evasion, the bobbing, the ducking, the weaving, the getting from side to side. He changed what he was doing from minute to minute.
Paul's going to start moving his head now. Going to start moving his head, slipping punches and slipping kicks. And he's got to, he can't afford to have Vic having him on the ropes. He's got to turn him around. Steve will just work there.
Well, it looked like Paul took a couple of really hard blows that round. A couple of round kicks, Grant. Right round kicks straight to the side of the head. And they're telling kicks, are they not?
Oh, take it out here. It's going to take some percentage out here. When you're getting hit in the head, Harold. I couldn't count how many times Steve Vic knocked people out with a kick to the head.
Right.
Straight in with a front kick, Vic went there.
Yeah.
And a right hook.
And a left hook.
And he's doing it all the time.
Paul's still going that left thigh. And it just doesn't seem to be having much of an effect there. He's not shepherding on it or moving
Vic's beating him to the work. Vic's beating Grant away. He's beating him to the punch. He's beating him to the kick. And he can't get anything out. Steve's slipping well.
Excellent.
Paul's is still walking up and taking shots.
Paul needs to... Here's that left thigh again, but it's just not counting. I'd love to see Paul bring one of his big uppercuts out, Grant. He's got some good uppercuts. He's got some great punches.
Well, Vic, he's just letting Steve Vic do what he wants. And Steve Vic just pushing back.
I know. And Steve is so superbly fit.
He slipped down there.
Steve is so fit. He's just not getting tired.
Well, he doesn't even look like he's been in a fight. Paul's walking up. See, Steve. Paul's going to get some lateral movement going here.
Oh.
Nice uppercut from Vic.
He took one and he gave one.
Get out of there, Steve. Move.
See, his corner's giving good instructions, getting out there. Keep moving.
He's right on his bike, Vic. Get out of there, Paul's still walking in. Vic working. Hands are going down in the low. Nice spinning kick by Steve Vic. Paul comes back to the thigh.
Paul's with it.
Vic works a right hand off front of head. Throws an uppercut, unsuccessful attempt.
Can Paul come back after this, Grant?
Anybody
he doesn't look like he can. Vic's the better fighter in this round.
Vic's on top of the moment.
He's still right on his feet.
Paul must get his hands up.
He's just letting Steve Vic work the way he wants to work.
It's almost like Paul's just getting through the round, mate. And I've got to tell you, Paul fell on that stool. He fell on that stool, mate. What round is that? Can you see?
Round seven this round.
Oh, geez, they're hard rounds, Grant. I mean, there's just no easing up in it.
This fight hasn't stopped for the six rounds.
I know. Just both fighters have given it all. For my money, I just see Paul copping too many hits, mate.
Paul's copping a lot of punishment because he's not getting respect of Steve Vic. He's going to hit Steve Vic with something hurting. If he gives Steve Vic room, Steve will kick and punch him.
And Steve Sides got him out, keeping him away, like you said, because he's ahead. Keep him away. No him fighting.
Every time Paul gets Vic on the ropes, Vic turns around and puts Grimer there.
That's right. Then, as you said, he gets out, he attacks somewhere else. They don't know
very
where he's coming.
Very intelligent fighter, Steve Vic.
Well trained, mate. Well trained.
Move, baby. Right, baby.
I was kicking in the thigh.
Well, falls into that left. Falls into that left. Oh, I see. Timeout.
Steve, suck him in. Look him up.
Back to the thigh for Grover. Grover Walker. Vic back to the thigh too.
Yeah. Vic looks so fresh and so good. I guess when Vic's little girl Tegan looks at this.
Oh, nice punch from Grover.
Tegan will be able to look at this and say, that's her daddy, and he's one hell of a fighter.
Certainly is.
One hell of a fight.
At this level of kickboxing, they're both awesome fighters.
They're world class, mate. Ranked 2 and 10 in the world.
Back to the body. Vic working with it. And Grimer's left thigh.
Move, baby!
Vic just pulls
still
those kicks out.
Still taking the fight up, Vic. Vic's still beating into the punch. Four comes forward.
Another good kick.
Move!
He's got to start working in closer. They're counter-kicking. They're counter-kicking.
Now, Vic's working Paul's left inner-outer. Inner-outer. On his left leg. Inner-outer. And Vic's moving around. Moving around. He's getting
there. That's a right hand from Grimer. Vic countering with kicks. Staying out of distance from punches.
Paul, that was well blocked, Grimer.
Vic comes back with a left turn to kick.
Big kick. Take it on his left.
Grimer, left turn to kick.
Paul took the kick so he could lay the punch. He
can't
saw it coming.
Ball, Grimer.
He's a tough.
Steve Vic on his body again, round the ring.
Yep.
Beating Grimer on the punch again. Left jab from Grimer. Right turn to kick from Vic.
And Paul is, oh dear. Come on, Paul. Give him your energy, Paul. Steve's pulling those kicks out. How does he keep doing them so quick, so fast?
He's a great kick. Another great round.
Boy, those rounds are just going so quick. They are going so quick, those rounds.
Well, this is round 8 coming up now. Paul's got to pull something out because on my scorecard, Steve Vick's well ahead on points.
You'd almost have to say, Grant, wouldn't you have to say that Paul's got to knock him out?
I think Paul Grimer would have to knock Steve Vick out to win at this stage of the fight.
Now, if anybody can do it, I'm telling you, Paul Grimer can do it.
Well, no doubt about that. Paul Grimer's a tough man. He's got a big punch, but Steve Vick's fighting a smart fight. He's beating him to the punch. He's not letting him anywhere near him.
He's strategically smart. He's planned what he's doing, and he's following his instructions from his trainers, and he's doing it well. He's not marked. The man's got a couple of red marks on his leg. He's got no marks on his face, no marks on his body. He's doing what he wants when he wants to do it.
Grimer up in round 8, Vic up in round 8.
Well, there it is. Number 8, just like Grant.
Now Grimer's on his bike a little bit, moving a bit. He should have been doing this earlier. Vic attacks that fire, Grimer's again. Attacks the thigh again of Grimer. What a flying Paul's forgotten in a leg check.
Well, I was just going to say, it seemed to me, at this fight, yeah. Paul stopped all the kicks with his leg instead of checking
nice
them.
Nice right hand from Vic.
Oh, yes.
Right over crack on Grimer.
Go for it, Steve! Sit down and go for it!
Nice leg check.
That's what he's got to do.
Nice left hook from Grimer.
He's been taking too many.
Paul Grimer's going to work there. Steve Vic got out. Smart fighter. Right hand from Vic. Inside on left, trying to kick to the head from
Paul
Vic.
Paul got the glove up, but just in time.
He still a small amount of head crash there. Left up.
Good uppercut.
Yeah. Nice trying to kick to the body from Vic.
The combinations just keep on coming.
Vic's working that leg of Grimer's now. Left jab from Vic. Vic's just doing what he wants here.
He does, and when he wants it.
Now Grimer comes back with an overhand right. There's no sting left in Grimer's punches.
I know.
Left jab, right hand from Vic.
You'd have to give it to Paul, though, for his conditioning.
Grimer keeps walking up, goes to Vic's leg. Vic with a side kick to Grimer's body.
He's a walk-up fighter, mate. He's not scared.
Right turn to kick from Vic. Right up a crack at Grimer. How tough are these guys?
He needs to pull it out of the bag, mate.
Oh, right hook from Vic, which wasn't successful.
But what a great...
Grimer's still in there, working away.
Into the front. Looks like an accidental kick
that I've got. Grimer walking up. Correct. Goes a big side.
Paul brought out a good right hand, isn't he?
It was a great round. Brian was still walking up. What an excellent athlete. Both these guys are great athletes.
They are hard athletes. They're hard, tough boys. Paul Grimer's in there giving it his all. Steve Vick's in there doing it all. They're two fantastic fighters. Either of them, pound for pound, Grant, are going to be amongst the best fighters this country has ever seen.
Oh, mate, they're up there world class. Well, Steve Vick's number two. Paul Grimer's number 10. Right, mate, what's that say for Australian kickboxing?
Mate, it says we're
these
up there with the
best.
These guys are tough guys. And these are the blokes who will train the next generation.
They certainly are, mate. We're in for some good fighters to come up soon. Big splash, Grimer walks up. Round about to start. What round is this? Round 8, is it?
Yeah, let's start. I think it might be 9, mate. Oh, there's that strong kick. But Paul takes that on the abs.
Nice kick from Vic.
So quick. Just so quick.
Grimer's still working Vic's left leg. Still walking up. Vic countered with some big punches then. Left hook and a kick. And a kick to Grimer's head. Yeah. Grimer trying desperately to pull something out here.
He's punishing with some of those kicks. Steve Vicks is being punishing here.
Nice kick. Nice right hand from Vic.
Yeah, Vicks.
Now Grimer's got to work now.
Yeah, but he's back in the corners.
Vic keeps turning Grimer around.
Absolutely. Just what you said. Paul walking up again.
Nice side kick. Nice kick.
Comes out. Paul moves aside, takes a Canada.
Again, he's working on that leg.
No leg checks for him.
Right uppercut from Grimer was successful. Vic comes back with a right hand of his own.
Steve Vick is fresh, mate. I hate to tell you that.
Beautiful combination of punches from Vick.
Has he been in the fight or what? He looks fresh.
Oh, he's an awesome athlete. Grimer hanging on there. Right uppercut from Grimer. Left hook from Grimer, unsuccessful.
Yeah, Billy Shulock's just saying, hey, we call break.
Front kick from Vick. Right turn and kick to the thigh from Vick.
Yeah.
Beautiful hand cover. Left turn and kick to the ring from Vick. Paul Grimer's got to work. He's got to do something.
I hate to say, Grant, I can't see it. Vick is too fresh.
Always pulling something. Got to keep him on the ropes. Hands up. Grimer working that thigh of Vic.
Left thigh.
There's some welts on Steve Vic's thigh.
Well, this is it, mate. This is the 10th round. I can't believe they've kept up this pace since round 1 to the round 10.
This fight has not changed pace from the time the first bell went. And it's the 10th and final round of this fight now.
I don't know how they can do it. I just don't know how they can do it. And
Paul
Steve
Grimer's
Vick,
taking some punishment. He's a tough man.
He is, but Steve Vick looks as fresh as the first round.
He's got a few welts on that left leg there. This is it. Grimer's going to knock Vick out here to win.
Well, or take his left leg and kick through it, and it doesn't look like that's going to happen.
Here we go, 10th and concluding round.
Well, and there it is, Grant. Grimer walks up again.
He's never done anything different.
Vick's on his guard. Vick will try and stay away from Grimer this round. I think he knows he's had on points. Steve's got some roll to that foot.
Oh, yeah.
There's another thigh kick from Grimer.
But he came back. Steve Vick's came back with one.
Vick coming back with some awesome combinations of punches.
Yeah.
Oh, big kick to the thigh.
Big kick. Look, he's just putting it all there.
Oh, right up the cut. He's got
to
follow it on. One punch won't do it.
Yes.
He's got to follow it up.
Go! He's fucked Steve, go! Just go on him! Front Steve! Stephen! Steve!
Front kick! Nice right turn. Yeah. From Grimer. Right hand from Grimer. This is the round Grimer's going to do it.
Right hand from Grimer. He's in the
right hand.
Steve Vick's coming back.
What a fight. He's going to toe to toe. 10th round, toe to toe.
This is a knockout. It ain't going to go Paul's way.
Behold, oh, big right punch hand from Driver.
But Steve's in there.
Big punch from Steve.
Big head from Steve.
There is Paul. Big punch.
Right
to toe to toe.
30 seconds.
Toe to toe this round. Toe to toe.
Okay. It's not got very long to go. 30 seconds. And I'd have to say,
big kick from
I
Vic.
Can't see
big punch from
Steve
Vic.
Vic losing this fight. I can't see it.
What a superb fight. Yeah. These boys are toe to toe.
Absolutely.
Steps back. Ryan walks forward.
They're potassium. They're more than gone.
Big on his bike. Ryan's still coming forward.
How can Steve Vic still kick so
right hand from Vic. Right turn,
still kicking.
Oh,
how can he do that after
big
10 rounds, man?
Big kick
after 10 rounds of
this,
fighting.
This boy's an awesome
jumping, spinning back kicks. And Paul still walks up.
That's the end of the fight. Great fight. What an excellent fight. What an excellent fight.
Well, Paul is still walking up. He's still doing his stuff.
I've got a headache.
I've got a sore throat.
This fight was a great fight.
It don't get any better.
Either fighter. Them boys are tough guys.
Tough, tough guys.
There goes the coins into the ring.
Just fabulous.
Payne Stewart happy with Steve Vick's performance.
How could you not be, mate? How could you not be happy?
Steve Vick, I'd say, has won this fight on points.
I would say
nothing away from Paul Grimes' toughness as an athlete. He just kept walking up, taking the fight, and he just kept walking up.
I agree, but you'd have to say Steve Vick on the night seemed to have what it took, mate. Take nothing from Paul Grimes, but he seemed to have just what it took.
It was a big fight.
Well, they've both given everything.
Instead of throwing the coins, could you walk to the ringside and throw them over the top rope? Thank you.
What a good idea. What a good idea.
Lucy, too. What did you think of that fight, Lucy? It was a great fight. Steve Vick's counterfighting was just totally exceptional.
What do you reckon, Adam?
Oh, you haven't keep taking, haven't Paul Grimes keep taking that punishment, just keep walking.
Good fight, Adam.
What sort of athlete
Adam,
is he?
Good fight. Steve Vick's. Oh, you have to.
And Gary Ciminello, 97 to 96, and still Super Commonwealth Champion from the blue corner, Steve Superkick Vick.
A world title fight. That's the level of these guys. They're both champions tonight. They will be both world champions. Steve Vick will be the super welterweight world champion. Paul Grimer will be the welterweight world champion. Congratulations to both fighters. Thanks everyone for coming along. Now I'll pass you over to Ian.
Steve, congratulations, mate. Once again, you are certainly a great champion from Queensland and also Australia, the Commonwealth. It's a daunting task to come here and fight Paul in front of his home crowd. You certainly fought with distinction tonight. Superior speed, Steve, that nickname you've got, the super kick, certainly paid the way. A very good fourth round with two knockdowns and then finishing on strongly towards the end. And I'm sure you would agree it was a different Paul Grimer this time than the one at Darling Harbour.
That's right. Paul put up, I don't need to say it, but Paul put up probably the most gallant and toughest fighter that I've had, certainly since I fought Hector Pina for the world title. I'd really like to thank Paul for fighting me, and I'm going to be a little bit arrogant here, but there's a lot of guys in Australia, namely guys like Tony Torcasio, Paul Briggs, other such fighters in my weight division, that have all said, they'll fight me, no worries. Now, all of those guys have been offered top money, and I mean top money, to fight me, and they've turned it down time and time again. And I'm just getting sick of all the crap that's going into these magazines. Paul Grimer is the only one with the guts enough to get in and have a fight. I'd like to commend you, Paul. I'd also like to thank... I'd also like to thank, from the very, very bottom of my heart, my two very good trainers and very good friends. First of all, Paul Rees, who's put all the cold mornings and all the hard work in the afternoons into me, and also Bain Stewart, who's really worked on my kicks and all the rest of it. Thanks, guys. I really appreciate it. And last but certainly not least, I'd like to thank you guys. Come along, support kickboxing. You're fantastic. Thank you.
Well, there is Steve Vick, certainly well spoken, and a good winner here this evening at the Central Coast Leagues Club in the Commonwealth.
Sorry, I'd also like to thank Mick for putting on a terrific show. Thank you.
Yes, certainly. Mick Fedavoli, without him, the night would not have been available. Well, for every winner, we have a loser. Paul, you're not a loser tonight. If courage could be measured, you'd be through the top of the ceiling, mate. And made another great performance, 100% better performance at Darling Harbour. You've certainly done the hard work tonight. And, mate, them early rounds, you might have slipped away to a little points lead there. But like a true champion, Paul, he come back at you at the end.
What can I say? First of all, I'd like to thank Steve for giving me a second chance. You don't get that very often in this business. Second of all, I'd like to thank the people that have helped me get to where I am today. I'd like to thank, first of all, my mum and dad, who I love very much, and have put in more than what I can say and got me to where I am today. Number two, I'd like to thank my trainer, Brian Freeman, who flogged me every afternoon to get me through this fight. I also like to thank three of the best martial artists in this country. That's Max Austin, John Suttle, and Chen Shuk Fei. Because they really worked me hard too. I also like to thank my wife Sandy, who's now pregnant, hopefully with my son, who I love very, very much. I'd also like to... And not illusions of what they think may have happened. I won't mention any names, but you know what I'm talking about. I think these magazines should start printing what really happened and not illusions of what they think might have happened. I'd also like to say to all the people out there that are fighters flapping their mouth saying they could take me, you know who you are. Mate, I had to work hard to get to number 10. Some of these fighters, their second pro fight, their first pro fight, they're fighting for a Commonwealth title. That sucks. I had to start at the bottom and work my way up. How about everyone else start doing that? These people that get their first fight and they want to fight me, I had to work my ass off to get where I am, and I'm not about to give anyone a shot that doesn't deserve it. If they want to come and fight me, come to my gym. They know where it is. They can spar me. But I'm not going to give anyone a shot that doesn't deserve it. You've got to work for it in this business. Okay? I'd also like to thank Steve Vick for being a good bloke, giving me the chance to fight him again. And for all you people here tonight, I know we're living in a recession, but anyone that pays money to come and see me fight, God bless you all. Thank you very much.
Paul, just before you go, speaking on Steve Vick, he's had one shot at a world title. Do you think, given the opportunity, again, he's capable of winning a world title, Steve Vick?
Steve Vick can go all the way, mate. He's got a heart. He's got a heart bigger than Farlap, mate. Tonight I hit Steve Vick with shots that should have killed a bull, and he's still standing after it. So all credit to Steve Vick. I'm not a bad loser. I put in 100% effort. I'm fighting out of my weight division tonight, people. I am a welterweight. Contrary to popular belief, I am a welterweight. Okay? Thank you very much.
Well, there he is, Paul Pitbull Grimer. Certainly a very good loser here this evening. But there he is, the man of the moment, the man of the Commonwealth. Commonwealth Super Welterweight Champion, Steve Superkick Vick. Steve, once again, congratulations. We look forward to seeing you back here, mate. You're welcome to come back anytime to Gosford, the Central Coast, mate. We love seeing you. There they are, two champions, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of Paul, to seeing you back here in the near future for another super night of kickboxing. Good evening.
Was nice, the party was pumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who?